Welcome back to another episode of Art Material Review. This is episode 2, and today I'm very excited because I'm going to be reviewing the very thing that made me want to make review videos. Today we are going to be reviewing Rosemary brushes. Now, many of you know Rosemary, many of you probably use them all the time. And in fact, many of my friends, professional artists, rely heavily on Rosemary brushes. And if you want a sure way to look cool and to look like you know what you're doing when it comes to art materials, buy Rosemary brushes. And I can say that without even reviewing them, without even really using them, because they have a certain cachet in the art world, and they are a sure, reliable way to send a signal to other artists that you know about art materials. Now, we're going to dig into this and see if there's really something to it, and I'm going to review these Rosemary brushes that I ordered and paid for. This is not sponsored by Rosemary brushes. In fact, I don't know at this very moment if I'm going to even like these and recommend them. And I'll tell you the truth, I honestly don't want to recommend them because I'm contrarian by nature and everybody likes these. I have friends who have their own line of brushes through Rosemary, and I'm bitter because they've never asked me to have a line of brushes. I don't even think they know who I am. So I'm a little resentful and I want to dislike Rosemary brushes, but I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna be honest, by the end of this video, you'll know if I like them or not, and I'll tell you the truth one way or the other. But I will say this, I'm already kind of impressed by this box. This is the box it came in. This is the box that was sitting at my door with Rosemary. I believe that's Rosemary right there. So let's go ahead and open up this beautiful box. I kind of want to be careful with it because I might, I don't know, might reuse it. Okay. A catalog, and there's Rosemary right there. And her dogs, they are Lakeland Terriers. It says so right there. Nice Lakeland Terriers. Let's see. Now they got all kinds, ooh, look, whoa, whoa. You see that? Is there like, it's like an entire wing of a bird on a stick. It's only 9 pounds. I don't know the conversion. What is that, like 55,000 American dollars? Master Workshops with Alex Venezia. Alex Venezia. This guy, he's like 20 something. I'm 40. And this guy paints so good that it's sickening. It's honestly sickening. I actually almost gave up painting when I saw his artwork. So that is a big strike against Rosemary. Hold on. Okay. Are we all good? This just fell out of the bag. Milk chocolate. I'm gonna eat this right now. We're gonna review the chocolate. This is Running on Empty Food Review. Got some stickers. Here's the brushes. Here's how they were packaged, taped to this cardboard. I got three types of brushes. So I have right here, these are the 11 inch sort of long handled classic pointed brush in size 4 and 6. I'll get back to those. And then here are the golden nylon. These are similar to what I normally use, not from them, but the kind of brushes I typically get. And so I got sizes 2, 4, and 6, which are the sizes I usually use. These are the 7-inch short handle, which are smaller. The bristle size for the size ends up being smaller because they're short handle. And then I got some sable brushes. These are the pure sable. And I got 4 and 2, size 4 and 2. So this will be a really good set of things to kind of experiment with. These bags are actually really, really hard to open. All right. Nice, nice, good, good, good condition. These are interesting. These are the sable here. Let me show you these up close. There we go. Each of these has its own little cylindrical cap over the top of the brushes, the bristles. These all look nice. Yeah, these look nice. I like it. And then we have these, which I wanted to get something a little different than what I normally use, just so we could have some variety. Now they have a lot of brushes, as evidenced by the catalog with a bird wing in it. So I'm sure there's a lot of other things that we could try here and review, but I got a small little smattering of brush types, the nylons that I used, the sable, and then these pointed rounds. I'm going to use all of these on paintings I'm currently working on, a couple paintings I'm starting, and you're gonna see some footage of me working with these brushes, and then I'm going to talk about that experience and a few things we're gonna be looking at. We're gonna be looking at their performance. I'm gonna compare them to other brushes I've used, kind of compare the cost, which is actually pretty good. It's the shipping and the time you wait for them that really is gonna be a factor there. But I don't know, I might have just waited for that chocolate alone, so. So I'm gonna begin my first impressions with the nylon rounds. This is a size 2, size 4, and size 6. Short handles, 7-inch handles. Here's a painting I'm working on. I have not painted any of this painting with these brushes. I just used other synthetic rounds that I get from arts and craft stores and from Jerry's Artorama. And we'll compare that at some later point when I review those brushes. But for now, we're gonna just talk about these and see how they perform. I think I'll start with the number 4, mostly just stick with that for my first impression. Nice middle size. Now, all this paint is dry here. Putting a little bit of solvent on there. We've got a nice tip. Everything looks good so far. No complaints. And let's go ahead and just sort of paint an area that is already painted. So far, nice and springy. It's that right balance. You know, in a brush like this, I want it to be soft so that I can blend, and I want it to bend easily, have a nice sort of malleability or softness to it, but at the same time, hold its shape, a certain springiness that I can kind of pull off, and the brush will immediately spring back to its point as it comes off. And so far, so good. My initial impressions are favorable in so far as the brush doing what I want it to do. And so that's good. So then it becomes a question of, does it hold up? So I'm putting it down, I'm pushing it down. Let's zoom in on that. I'm pushing it down. You can see it splays out, and then I'm tapering. And as I taper and lift up, it comes back to its point. And I still have the point, so I can reliably go up here and do a little crease. If I wanna use the full body here and then taper up. Now I'm gonna wipe it off with the paper towel, so I'm not adding any more paint. And now I'm just gonna sort of feather out with the tip. Nice control. And it's just a short period of time, but it's doing exactly what I want it to do. Wipe off a little bit more paint. Now let's go and mix a different color. Add a little bit of red in there. Let's just see how it behaves in a new area. Let's say I was going to go down and paint more of this cheek right now. Let's see how it goes on and if there's any kind of issue spreading onto a new area of the linen canvas. Yeah, no complaint in that regard. I'm not super happy with my color choice there, but that's me. I can't blame Rosemary for my bad painting skills. I need a workshop with Alex. So going back and forth between painting in the new area, I mean, I really actually am quite satisfied with how that filled in. And that tip to the brush is really looking good. I know it's only been a couple minutes. We'll see how it plays out. Okay, now we're gonna do my first impressions of these pointed rounds, and I'm gonna be using this copy I'm doing of a John William Waterhouse painting, The Lady of Shalott? Shalott? So let's go ahead. I'm gonna use this brush a little differently. I don't really feel like it's something, this is dry by the way, I don't really feel like this is something I can model the same kind of form, but it might be a really great brush for doing an underpainting or massing in areas. And in this case, because it's a coarser brush, it's not as malleable, it doesn't bend as much, and I would say the tip frays more, but it's also good at kind of getting into the weave. If I was painting on cotton canvas, not linen canvas, if I was painting on acrylic sizing or gesso primed canvas, I probably would really like having this stiffer brush because I feel like I could put more paint down, you can load it up more, there's more spaces between the bristles, and it's also, I can kind of apply more pressure and kind of almost stipple into those cracks. So it's really nice for maybe a thicker underpainting. And it'll be interesting to see how it holds up over the week. First impressions are fine, not my favorite kind of brush, but I don't see it as being appreciably different. And especially when it comes to these size brushes, I feel like I typically pay more for these kind of brushes. I can't quote exactly what the price is, but the price here at Rosemary was actually, like I said earlier in the video, very surprisingly affordable. I really had the wrong impression, and I apologize profusely to Rosemary and her terriers, Tiger Lily and, I don't know, Tiger Lily, I'm sorry. Other terrier, I'm sorry too. Its textures actually feel like sometimes when I get these kinds of brushes, you know, just regular art stores, it definitely poofs up even right away when I'm painting with it. And I haven't even had to wipe this clean with a paper towel or reshape it. So that's nice. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool brush. Yeah, it's really uniform. The marks are really uniform. It's interesting. Okay. Yeah, let's see how the week plays out with that one. All right, let's go through some first impressions of the sable brush here. I've never really liked sable brushes. This is the Pure Sable number 2. Now I have this painting here that I did some months ago and a little bit on it recently and then kind of screwed it up. I don't know if you can see this here in the video, but I completely scraped this with a palette knife. So it's very grainy. And I'm thinking, well, I need to go back in here and kind of redraw and restate some things. So I think this brush, just given its shape and sort of long sort of bristles, I feel like I could maybe use it to really kind of get back in there and add this detail again. So let's see if it does a good job at that. I will say this, it's already been fraying. And maybe that's part of its charm. Maybe if you're painting like grass or hair and you want sort of a fibrous fray, but I don't really like that. I like being in control. So it seems fine with the line. Let's see if we can do any amount of modeling back with it. Let's get into some form. I really can't stand the way these long bristle brushes mix paint. And I think that's one of the reasons I stay away from them in general. And this isn't really Rosemary at all that I'm being critical of here. This is anytime I use something with longer bristles like this, mixing with them is painful, which means you almost kind of have to pre-mix with either a different brush or a palette knife. And I don't like doing that. I like mixing with the brush I'm using because it's much more sort of immediate. I can mix paint. There's like a real rhythm. So I don't like the mixing with it, but that's not specific to Rosemary. It's this type of brush. Although I will say the modeling isn't bad right now. I'm liking the way I can taper with this. I'm liking the tip of it. Definitely model and finesse here more than I was just expecting I'd be able to, based on how the brush was sort of collapsing in on itself as I was mixing. Yeah, nice finesse. I haven't wiped the brush clean on a paper towel, and just enough paint has come off of it. I don't know if you noticed this in the video because it's very subtle, but I just took that band of value I did right before the crease and was able to blend that up and out, and that actually was quite nice. All right, so those have been my first impressions. I'm going to paint all week with these, and I will let you know what I think after that week. All right, here we are. It's a week later. I've been painting all week with these brushes. And I have some final thoughts here. The nylon rounds, the ones that I mostly use, that I painted most of these paintings with, they were fantastic. And there's two ways I would talk about their durability. In a single session over, say, 2-3 hours, or even all day painting, if I switched between paintings, they were very consistent. The marks they made were consistent. The way the paint loaded on them, the way the paint came off, was very consistent. And then they were consistent throughout the week. And again, I just cleaned them easily, you know, soap and water at the end of the day, made sure all the paint was out of them. And they were great every day for an entire week, and I can only imagine they'd still remain good for several weeks on end. They are absolutely better than craft store brushes, synthetic rounds that I get all the time from Michaels or anywhere else. But these Rosemary nylons are definitely better. They are more consistent in a single session, and they're consistent over the span of an entire week painting with them almost every day. The classic pointed brushes here were actually kind of interesting. I didn't know what to do with them. You would have seen earlier that I tried underpainting with them, and that was fine. Certainly worked in that regard. They filled in the canvas well. But I ended up using it to kind of smooth out paint that I was painting with my nylon brushes. And they actually created this nice uniform texture. They held their shape pretty well. They sort of poofed out by the end of a week a little bit, but that kind of works in their favor. in terms of softening against that canvas texture. The brush I like the least, no surprise, was the Sable. I just don't really quite know what to do with them. It's not that I don't recommend Rosemary's Sable, it's just that as a brush type, they're not my favorite. They don't feed into my process that well. So I probably won't be getting the Sables again unless I do a different kind of review, but I'm definitely going to get the Nylon rounds again from Rosemary. I'm definitely going to get the classic pointed because I actually thought I was able to do some interesting things. It was kind of exciting to do something different with them. Great brushes. Now it all comes down to whether or not they're worth it. Price per brush, they weren't bad. They were only like $4, $5, $3, depending on the size. On the other end of that, I paid like $22 for shipping for the 7 brushes. That's high. Obviously, that's more than I would spend on shipping if I just drove to the art store. But I can't get brushes this good unless I have them shipped to me. And maybe the shipping's a little bit more because they're coming from England and I live on the East Coast, United States. And so it's gonna be relatively high shipping cost. So I'll make sure that I order in bulk because I do think they're worth it. And if you want to work in my method and try some of the ideas you see in my videos, get these nylon rounds, sizes 2, 4, and 6. That's what I painted with mostly all week. And I think they're really, really great. If you like more texture, more painterliness, I think these classic rounds are great. And if you want to punish yourself, get the Sable. No, I'm kidding. Sables, look, if you like Sables, please let us know in the comments what you do with them. Because I don't know. I'm not a Sable fan. But overall, Rosemary brushes, despite my best efforts, I actually love them. I'm going to order them from now on. I'll use other brushes still, I'm sure, but I'm going to definitely restock on these. Well done, Rosemary. Well done. It's been a week. What were the Terriers? Lakeland. Lakeland Terrier. Thank you, Rosemary and your Lakeland Terriers. Thank you so much for checking out this video. If you like my content and you want to see more reviews and more art tutorials, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Or you can check me out at patreon.com/ScottWaddell. Or my website, scottwaddellfineart.com. I'll see you in the next video.